An exclusive world premiere sneak preview. The following is a copyright presentation of Totown Communications Company Limited in association with Totown Records. This Totown Digital Media presentation is an exclusive world premiere sneak preview of never-before-seen footage of jazz greats Miles Davis and Dizzy Gillespie. Stay tuned to Japan Journal for announcement of the upcoming release of the documentary I Remember Miles, produced and directed by Malcolm W. Adams for Totown Digital Media Japan.
Pleasure to meet Miles for the first time in St. Louis when he was a youngster. He was still going to school. Later on, he came to New York. He finished Juilliard. Miles did. He graduated from Juilliard. And at the time, I was just beginning to get my band together. You know, five pieces here and five pieces there. And so I formed a band and took it into the Three Deuces for maybe 7 or 8 weeks. And at the time, Dizzy, after the Eckstein organization broke up, Dizzy was about to form his own band. There were so many things taking place then. I mean, it's hard to describe.
We were playing a running style of trumpet, mm-hmm. which, if you play a running style of trumpet, you have to know something about chord progression and theory, because you can only play so much that you hear. You know, you can only hear so much, but if you have the knowledge, you can take it farther. You know, say you hear a run by Dizzy in one key. If you have the knowledge of theory, you can put it in both keys at the same time. Mm-hmm. If you have the knowledge of theory, you can put it in a whole tone scale, minor scale, right? Half and half, half major, half minor, half diminished, half whole tone. So you have to have that knowledge. So that's the only thing I heard. Lil Davis, you gotta learn your chords. That's the only thing I heard from older musicians. Not you playing jazz, it's you gotta learn this change. What was that change? You gotta lift the mouth side. You don't squeeze in, you do this. But don't do that, don't play. When a singer is singing, play in between when he stops. That kind of advice I got. But never you playing jazz and what would they tell me? Like a white man's concept, they would say, well, Miles, you know, your grandfather was lynched and you have this feeling in you, that's the reason you playing this D minor 7 chord. No. You play it because you study it. You know, and the feeling comes because you enjoy playing music and what it does to you and what it makes you feel like doing musically. If you're not a musician, it makes you want to make love, dance, applaud, pat your foot. It might make you hungry, you know, might make you sad, cry, might make you laugh. That's it.
What were your earliest recollections of Miles? When did you first meet him, and what were the circumstances?
I was with the Bill Eckstein band. We played in St. Louis, and he wanted to sit in. So I told him, he said, well, let him sit in, man. And so he came in and sat in and had a good time. So right after that, man, he came to New York. Well, you see, Miles, he wasn't, he didn't have he didn't know that you're supposed to be a jazz artist, you got to know how to play the piano. You got to know the keyboard of the piano. And so when he came to New York, But he was funny too, boy. He came to my house one day. He came up there one day with records. He was one of my records. So he said, "I want you to show me something." He said, "Yes." One note. He said, "Where does that note come from?" I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Well, in this solo, you play more than that. What does it come for in the chords?" I said, "Give me this record." I put it on the record. And then he played this, and he said, "Right there, right there." I said, I knew exactly what he was saying, I knew what he was talking about. I said, wait a minute. So I go over to the piano. And right there, I hit that chord. And it all spread out, the chord like this. And I hit it like that. And then I said, "Right there." And showed him what finger it was, you know. He said, "Oh, that is." So he's a very, very, very good student, you know, because he could play, but he didn't know the keyboard.
Give me the mouthpiece. No, that. No. It's like it's like when you hear a police siren go by. It's like, you know, like that. See, it's different here. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Actually, you can control it better here. See, I mean, you don't have to play. Trumpet is meant to be played like that. I mean, they just that's the way you see them, like this marching. You know, because you can't march like this, right? Because you bump into something.
You say it is meant to be played up?
No. It's an instrument is meant to be played wherever you feel comfortable. See, and notes and sounds in this room will sound different in that corner, in the middle. See how open it sounds when I do like this? Because it's right in the middle of the room. But if I want it to sound, see, it's a different sound, you know? You might not hear it because it's me.
You can hear it.
And it says, you know, you recognize my tone. That's another thing I like about the Japanese people. They recognize my sound. I could be in a room and play a note and they'll recognize it like a voice. You know, like it's you can tell Frank Sinatra or Michael Jackson, one of them.
Sure.
Yeah.
I know, man. I've seen them react to you and they love you. The country, the industry here loves you. You have a presence here through your television commercial. We're going to try to get some of them and show them in this piece, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Given it. But you don't do it in the States. And would you?
This Totown Digital Media presentation is an exclusive world premiere sneak preview of never-before-seen footage of jazz greats Miles Davis and Dizzy Gillespie. Stay tuned to Japan Journal for announcement of the upcoming release of the documentary I Remember Miles, produced and directed by Malcolm W. Adams for Totown Digital Media Japan.